Snipe Squad, what is up, man? It is your boy Sniper Jones Jones, and this is not the regular intro to the video. We literally just hit 18K. I'm just seeing it now. I'm recording my video. I happened to look down at my actual YouTube channel to copy a link to put in this video, and bang, I see the 18K. I'm super thankful, man. Thank each and every last one of y'all. I know this is not a Grammy speech. I'm not going to give y'all a Grammy speech, but I do want to say from the bottom of my heart, man, I believe that each and every last one of y'all can do whatever y'all want. Now, I get criticized all the time for being motivational. I take that. I motivate my audience. I get criticized all the time for it. But at the end of the day, man, I just want to tell y'all, whatever you're going for in life is possible. The reason why I can say that is because, bro, I didn't have none of this figured out. I never edited a video in my life. I never recorded a video in my life. My first time owning the laptop was when I got a YouTube channel, which was like a year and a half ago. 2 years, something like that. Anyway, man, long story short, I can speak to it because every single day I bust my butt, I wake up, I put out these videos every single day, man. I put everything into it. I make the proper sacrifices and I get a glory to God. But man, I promise you, if you put that work ethic into your craft and you actually go 100% in and you believe in yourself, people not gonna believe in you. People don't believe in me. But your belief that you're gonna succeed has to be stronger than their doubt. So in closing, man, I'm not gonna talk too much because I know we got a video to record. But at the end of the day, I'm nothing without the audience. I'm nothing without you guys. And I wanted to personally thank you before I recorded today's video. 18K is amazing. 100K before the end of the year. I appreciate y'all, man. Now, back to the regular schedule intro. Let's get it. Snipe Squad, what is going on? Back again. It is your boy, Sniper Jones Jones, and we are back with another video for your head top. Okay, as y'all can see, I added a little bit more emphasis in that intro because in the comments, somebody said I didn't have a lot of energy. Y'all know I'm known for energy. That's on dog. Anyways, welcome back to another video. Welcome back to another video. I am super excited, man. I am Sniper Jones. If you're new to my channel, I drop daily videos for your head top, man. Sneakers, clothing, reviews. I want to get a lot more into clothing. That's on the way. Just be patient with me. But if you missed yesterday's episode, yesterday's video, I would say, yesterday's video was an unboxing of some great, great products that Rejuvenator sent over to me. What I want to do is tell you guys, if you have not seen that video, go over there and give it a look because I am doing a giveaway with Rejuvenator. So here's one of the products that you can potentially win and just so have it. It's actually matching my shirt. But anyways, man, this is a full cleaning kit. I'm giving away two of these. One is like in a tube-like packaging, but it's the same things in there. You get the brushes, you get the laundry system bags, you get the adjustable shoe trees, you get the solution. There's so much stuff in here, even a microfiber towel. The only thing you have to do is go to my Instagram, follow me, like this pic, comment under done, and also, of course, subscribe to the channel. Do those small steps and you can potentially win that giveaway. And do not be upset if you don't win because, man, I plan on doing a lot more giveaways in the future. But more importantly, if any of you guys actually want to go and just shop for your own Rejuvenator products, I do have a link down below in the description. And I also have a promo code Sniper. If you use that promo code, you'll get 10% off any purchase. Just after you get done buying everything you buy in, when you get ready to check out, use the discount code Sniper and you'll get 10% off that whole entire purchase. Every dollar counts, every dollar counts. So for the ones that's used to coming back to the channel, man, y'all know I do this thing called Kickstory. Kickstory is something I absolutely love to do because you rarely see stuff like this on YouTube, where instead of doing something boring like showing you guys a huge collection video, I basically break down sneakers in my collection and one by one. So I'm showing you my sneaker collection, but more importantly, I'm telling you the story behind it. I feel like that's important because, one, it's a conversational piece. I love to have the conversation with you guys, talk to y'all about shoes, and what better to talk about than the crazy stories that went in copping some of these. Now, I've dropped a lot of videos, man. I appreciate everybody who's been supporting this whole little series, we can call it, but today's video is actually on the oldest pair of sneakers I have in my collection. Now, I am young, you know what I'm saying? It's not new to nobody. I'm young, but that does not mean I have not been going back in the archives copping sneakers. Now, when I say the oldest pair of my collection, that does not mean like the first pair I bought. I mean like the oldest due to release date. Now, even though, like I said, I'm pretty young and you know, a lot of people have been collecting before me, I still used to always go back and cop grails that I always wanted and I can never get my hands on. Now, I have a lot of sneakers behind me. A lot of these though, man, or actually a few of these, one of these I'm gonna point out to you in today's video. Some shoes cannot be worn, which seems crazy because that's the whole point of shoes, right? But before you get confused, I'll tell you why, man. Sometimes when you get a sneaker and it's old, I know a lot of people out there understand and a lot of people don't. Listen, all sneakers, the sole is nothing but glue. After a long point of time, that sneaker cannot be worn just due to like the glue. The glue does not hold up for years and years and years. That's one of the main reasons why I tell everybody to wear your shoes, because number one, you bought it, so wear it. And then number two, if you wait too long, you're not gonna be able to wear it at all. Granted, you can wait 2-3 years like some people do, but I'm talking about, man, some of this is probably as old as some people watching. Some of these shoes I have is like old as my subscribers, which is crazy. So one thing I love doing is reading over the comments in my kick stories, because these are supposed to be relatable topics and relatable videos. So what I want y'all to do is comment right now. Just comment, what is your oldest sneaker in your collection? I'm gonna read over these, and whoever comments the oldest sneaker in your collection, I will shout you out in tomorrow's video. But I need to know, what is the oldest shoe in your collection? Tell me what it is and how old is it? At the end of the day, I'm kind of nosy. I want to know, am I the only one collecting these old shoes? Now, I haven't bought none in a while, no old shoes in a while, but I had my times where I was going back and copping things that I really wish I had. Nevertheless, man, my oldest shoe in my collection is Aya. This is the Varsity Blue Pro B Foamposite Pro. Now, before we get started, I know a lot of y'all are probably confused, because you've probably seen a Foamposite colorway like this recently, but that was a remake. The biggest difference between the two is this Varsity Blue Foamposite Pro B has the black bottom, and the newer pair decided to go with the cobalt blue bottom with the cobalt blue upper. Now, it's a few small differences between its shoes, but the biggest difference of them is the sole. So yes, they did re-release this like 2 years ago, maybe, called the cobalt blue Foamposite Pro, but like I said, the biggest difference is the sole was not black. Okay, the sole was not black. Now, a lot of y'all probably like, well, Snipe, that shoe can't be that old, man. Like, you know, how old is it? And you're wrong, dog. You're wrong. The release date of this sneaker, bro, I know a lot of y'all not gonna be nowhere close. Matter of fact, yes, the release date of this shoe. Of course, some of y'all gonna cheat and wait to the end to tell me, but at the end of the day, I still want to do it because it's kind of fun for me. This sneaker was released 2001, bro. This shoe was 18 years old. Probably like 17 years and some change, because it's not the exact day it was released, so it's not 18 years. But y'all get what I'm saying, man. 2001, it's 2019. This shoe was released 18 years ago. Now, remember that conversation I talked to you guys about the gluing? That's real. Now, this shoe cannot be worn. I'm not gonna hold you. Look at that, bro. This shoe definitely couldn't be worn, and I don't want to keep pulling it because that's definitely not good for the sneaker, but let's just say the condition for these cannot be that worn. Even though if you look at the Foamposite, the actual upper is in great condition. This shoe, think about it. This shoe, hell yeah, it's some beat stains right there, but this shoe is from 18 years ago. This is not bad condition for an 18-year-old shoe. I know shoes that look way worse than this, and they're like 2-3 years old. 18. Some of my subscribers is like 18 years old. Some of y'all like 16, 17. Some of y'all 15. This shoe is older than you. And I have it, man. That lets you know I'm a true Foamposite head. Now, I have older Foamposites as well. I have the original Dr. Doom Foamposite. These are re-released as well, but this is the original. I believe this one was released like 2006. Don't quote me on that. I believe, man. And the inside of that, look at that insole. The newer pair did not have that insole. These re-released in like 2017, maybe 18. I don't know when they re-released, but they sat on shelves, which is disgusted my stomach, because I paid a lot of money for this shoe and it just re-released, and they didn't even like this shoe here. So the Varsity Pro B Foamposite Blue, at least they made a difference with the sole swap. Okay, the newer pair does not have a black sole. This pair was a complete rip-off. There was no way to separate this pair from the pair that's actually re-released a few years ago. The only difference is that insole right there. I had the original box, but as y'all know, I throw a lot of my boxes away when I get the container, so I still do not have the original box now, but this is the original. I also have this original. This is the first Varsity Pro B, Varsity Red Foamposite Pro, and this one was released like 2002, 2003. It was after this one, but these are the two originals. Now, they re-released this one as well. They decided to keep the black soles on a re-release. Oh, snap. But the biggest difference was they had like metallic going all through the upper of the shoe. Like, it was different. They had like a shinier, darker metallic red going throughout the entire upper. This shoe was old. Look at the yellow one on that Nike sign. Look at the back heel drag. This shoe was old. This shoe was like 15 years old, man. 15 to 17 years old. I'm not sure when it dropped. I believe it was 2002 or 2003. If anybody knows, let me know down below in the comment section. But guys, this is what I'm telling y'all, man. I have been a foam head for a very long time, and I have been collecting foams for a very long time. I bought these sneakers a while back, actually. Do y'all remember that story I told y'all how I caught my first sneaker? Yeah, man, college refund checks. When I got my first college refund check, I started my collection. And these were two of the first sneakers I got. These were on my grails list growing up. Because at the time, man, it was like 2012, and I wanted some sneakers from 2001. Even back then, when I started collecting sneakers, it was old. Like, the shoe was old. So I would tell my boys, like, yo, man, I'm copping this, man. And like, even though it's 11 years old, like, man, I'm telling you, man, I'm copping this. And they'd be like, bro, there's no way you're gonna cop that. Look at that, it's like $500. Just like, da 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 da. Now, I didn't spend that amount of money, God knows, but I wound up getting these pairs. And I still remember the feeling they gave me when I got these. And I still remember how excited I was running through the house. And people laugh at it now because phone posits are kind of irrelevant in the sneaker community. Everybody wants Adidas, everybody wants the Jordans, everybody wants the Off-White. So these are way pushed back in the back, like way. But hey, man, like, I'm gonna stay me. You know, I'm not gonna let YouTube dictate what I like, man. At the end of the day, we all owe ourselves and we all owe our viewers, man, to be 100. But what we like, this is my demographic. I love the Foamposites still. They have not created colorways recently that makes me want to buy them, to be honest. The floral pair is actually pretty dope. The Sequoia pair is actually pretty dope. I might get both of those, but I'm still waiting. But all my supporters, man, y'all know, when it comes to the foams, Snipe always will have a love for the foams. And if this doesn't show it, I don't know what will, man. Like I say, this pair is from 2001. This is the oldest sneaker I have. It's 18 years old and it's unwearable. Now, I think what I want to do is probably like have somebody re-glue these. Cause I do want to wear them. It's like I've never worn them, you know. It, like, I should have and I didn't. It was a regret of mine. So if anybody out there is good with customs, and like, I have to see some work, I'm just not gonna toss my shoes to anybody, you know. But if anybody out there is good with customs, if y'all can properly re-glue these, then please let me know. I will shout you out after, you know, your work is done and I'm showing off the shoe. I will shout you out, man, and make sure you get as much love as possible. But I would like to wear these one day, bro. I just can't in this condition. So if any of y'all able to make that happen, if you know anybody that's able to make that happen, tell them to come through, watch this video. Hit me up on Instagram or whatever. I'm open to it. Just please, man, let me know if anybody can re-glue these so safely. I'm not talking about to where, you know, I'm walking and I sprained my ankle or something. Safely, just re-glue these. I don't think it's tough. I watch a lot of restoration videos. I'm just not gonna try it myself. I'm not gonna do that. So once again, guys, this is my oldest sneaker in my collection, man. This shoe was from 2001. I still can't believe I still have it. And like I said, it's pretty much in good condition, to be honest with you. Do not forget down below in the comment section to comment your oldest sneaker in your collection. Number one, I'm nosy. And number two, I want to know if anybody out there really going back copping old heat. What is your oldest pair? Last but not least, I got to say, everybody want to be famous. But who really putting in that work though? Snipe Squad, I love y'all. Dream big.